Genesis 8:22, while the earth remains, seed time to harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night shall not cease. 8:22 says, as the earth remains, seed time and harvest shall not cease. Well, that means that seed time and harvest is one of the main ways God will get increase into your business, which means that you have to sow in order to reap, which means that God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that's what you shall reap. If you're not sowing seeds, you're not going to reap a harvest. And I'm not just talking about sowing money into a collection plate either. Genesis 26:12, and then Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year 100-fold, and the Lord blessed him. Just like Isaac, if you want your business to be successful, you're going to have to sow into your business. So that's what I'm saying. I'm not just talking about sowing money into church. Yeah, we got to sow money into church, but you also got to sow into your business. Think about what Isaac had to do. He had to sow into a land of famine. There was a famine in the land. He actually sowed physical seed in the ground, and in that same year, he produced a bumper crop. So right now, in this time of recession, you got to actually sow into your business. You can't be afraid to spend money. One of my Facebook friends, Natasha, she said that if you don't have the time to run your business, you should hire a part-time babysitter. When you hire a part-time babysitter, that's sowing into your business. When you got to hire a web designer to do something for you, that's sowing into your business. Don't be afraid to sow into your business, because whatever a man sows, that's what he shall reap. Proverbs 22:29, seest thou a man diligent his business, he shall stand before kings, he shall not stand before mean men. Not only you got to sow money into your business, you got to sow time into your business. You got to put the time in to produce the harvest. Money is like time, and time is like money. As you sow your time into your business, you got to be diligent and do exactly what God calls you to do. So you got to take this thing seriously. So I said, you got to sow. You got to sow money. You got to sow time and watch it increase. Malachi 3:8, will a man rob God? You have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. Ye are cursed with a curse. You have robbed me, even this whole nation. Malachi, that if you don't give tithes and offering, then it's useless. You're still cursed with a curse. So sowing money, sowing time is like an offering. But if you haven't tithed yet, the offering is irrelevant. So don't forget, you got to tithe. This is Amos Johnson coming to you with you another biblical entrepreneurship to help you develop and grow the business that God's called you to. Talk to you guys later.